Okay, so we're going to have a discussion, or I'm going to demonstrate to you how to code your data. But before I do the demonstration, I just have to provide you some basic understanding of some terms, right? So the first term I just want to let you know is the coding strategy. So what is coding strategy? So think about coding strategy as a technique used to help in coding your data. The technique used to help you to identify significant information and try to assign labels to those significant information. So that's simply a coding technique. So before I talk more about the types of coding strategies, just a brief information or brief background about the data that I'm going to use to demonstrate the coding process. The problem is there is a growing experience of burnout among primary healthcare physicians. So that's the problem. So the purpose is to find out the cause or to explore the cause and the solution of burnout among primary healthcare physicians. And so these are the questions that we're going to use to help us identify significant information from the data and then develop code. So the first question is, what are the causes of burnout among primary healthcare physicians? And the second one is, what can be done to reduce burnout among primary healthcare physicians? And the research method is phenomenological approach. So the phenomenological approach is more of capturing participant experience. So you interview participants for them to share the experience, in this case the experience of burnout, to you in terms of the solution and also the causes of it. So we also use structured interview. So structured interview is interviewing participants based on a specific group of questions, and each participant will be asked the same question and then in the same sequence. So in this case, each participant was asked 9 questions, and I'll go into detail. So now that you have the background information about the data that we're going to use, let's talk a little bit about the demographics. So 5 participants were interviewed, and these are their ages, and also you can see the gender, 3 females and 2 males, and also the year of experience, and also the ethnicity. So these are the demographic information that will be taken into consideration when you are reviewing their transcript. As you can see from this demographic information, we're going to have 5 transcripts. Why? Because we interviewed 5 participants. So back to coding strategies. So there are 3 main types of coding strategies. We have description-focused coding, we have interpretation-focused coding, and we have presumption-focused coding. So let's start with the description. So think about this way. Description. You are describing what you see in the data, right? So this means that you are going through the data and then identifying significant information. Any information that can help you to address your research question, you identify that. Then you ask yourself, what is this statement saying, right? So what does it say? Or you first have to understand the statement and then come up with a phrase that represents that statement or the information that you think is significant. So for description, you are just describing what participant has given you. So you are just like a journalist. You go and see what is happening and then report or describe to your audience what you saw, right, or what you are seeing. So in this context, when you are looking at your transcript, you select significant information and then make sure that you understand what you have selected. Then based on your understanding, you generate a code to represent the asset that you have selected. So that's all about the description focused coding. So let's go to interpretation-focused coding. Interpretation, you are making sense of the participant information. You go to the transcript, you select significant information, you make sure that you understand that information, and you ask yourself, what does this information mean? What is the meaning of the information based on the meaning you generate code to represent that? Except. So the last one is presumption-focused coding. So what you're doing is that you see the significant information that you have identified from the data as evident in the data, right? So based on the evidence that you have, can you draw conclusions from the evidence that you see? So the conclusion will be the code, right? So the conclusion will be the, will help you to develop the phrase or the code, right, that you're going to use to represent the information that you see in the data. So you select significant information, you make sure that you understand, you see it as evidence, and based on this evidence, what conclusion do you want to make? Based on the conclusion, you generate code to represent the evidence that you have. So you can see that the codes are the conclusion, and then the codes are supported by the evidence that you have identified from the data. So these are the three coding strategies. So you ask yourself, based on the data that we're going to analyze, what kind of coding strategy should we use? Description-focused coding, or interpretation-focused coding, or presumption-focused coding? So first of all, there are two things that you have to look into before you decide which coding strategy. The first one is the purpose of the study, right? Looking at the purpose of the study, let's go back to the purpose of the study. So the purpose of the study is to explore the causes and solutions, right, of burnout. And so looking at the purpose, we are looking for the causes and solution, and that information, based on the transcript, you have been given that information. Let's look at one of the transcripts. So this is from participant one. They were asked directly the experience of burnout, and then they were asked about the causes and also the solution of burnout. So based on this one, you can see that you can directly get the information from the what they have said, right? See, so looking at the purpose of the study, which is all about exploring the causes and the solution of burnout, and also looking at participant transcript, you can see that the information is right there for you. You are looking for the causes and the solution. The information is right there, so it's not hidden. So this means that using description-focused coding will be the best, because you are just describing what participant has told you or provided to you, right? So let's go back to the PowerPoint. Is describing the data all a phenomenon your intent? Yes, we want to describe the solution and the causes of burnout. Is relevant information generally hidden in the data? No, the information is not hidden. The information is right there for you. Because the information is not hidden, description-focused coding will be the best, right? If the information was hidden, right, and then you have to make sense of participant response before you can address the research question, then interpretation-focused coding will be the best. If, let's say, you want to develop a theory or explain a specific phenomenon, then you can use the presumption-focused coding, right? So in this case, looking at the purpose of the study and the data that we have, description-focused coding will be the best strategy in terms of developing codes.